way to end conflict is to remove the barrier that is between them. And Jesus did this by dying for the sins of all. Not only for Gentiles, but for everybody. Making the salvation available to all. But here's what's interesting. Despite the fact that Jesus says he has destroyed these barriers, we still find reasons to divide. We still find reasons to be divided from each other, find reasons for division. And so here's something I want to say. If we read a text like this and we see that Jesus literally shed his blood to tear down walls, then we should not be building up new ones. That if Jesus brought us near by removing this wall, we should not be building up new ones. So here's a question I have for you: what kinds of walls do you see the church at large building up? We can get a little closer to home. What kind of walls have you seen built up in our church?
Our church.
What kind of walls have you seen built up in your small group?
Of course.
We should watch out for walls. Because we see that it matters deeply to Jesus that there not be anything that divides us. That he's made us one and we should fight for that. But here's the encouraging thing. It's that Jesus has not said, you need to find a way to become one. Jesus has not said, you need to find a way to become unified. Jesus says, I have already made you one. Jesus said, I've already done the hard work. So by the time we get to the next chapter, Jesus says, I want you to be eager to maintain the spirit of peace, the unity and the bond of spirit of peace, right? He says, I want you to be eager to maintain the unity. He said, I already gave you the unity. I just need you to maintain it. And God has called us to do just that. So I want you to beware of raising up any walls.